First, to give you a glimpse into the future, we're going to take a quick look through the eyes of Derek. Derek is the IT manager at Happy Frog, and so he has access to a great deal of IT information that's been shared with him by his IT service provider. You'll note his left sidebar is quite full of information. For now, we're simply going to look at how Derek will navigate the many passwords he has access to. First, he can simply browse the whole list. Typing a few characters in the search box will instantly filter the list to find what he's looking for. For example, all application passwords, or all passwords for the Bridgeworks app. From anywhere in MyGlue, simply hitting Q will bring up the quick search, and Derek can jump to the password he's looking for. In this case, Salesforce admin. Now he can use the password. To log into Salesforce, Derek simply clicks the link, then uses these icons to copy the information to his clipboard and log into Salesforce. Note, if he was at a screen where others might be watching, we can do this without even revealing the password. If Derek is viewing this on his own laptop, but needs to type the password into someone else's screen, he can simply view the password with the Show Password button. Note, each time the password is copied or shown, there will be an entry written to detailed activity logs, showing who accessed the password and when. This can be excellent to track down who made changes to a system. Okay, let's leave Derek to one side. He has quite a lot going on in his MyGlue. We're going to switch over to Lucas. Lucas works at a construction company called SkyTouch, and SkyTouch is just starting to roll out MyGlue to their teams. Lucas is one of the first few people to be invited. Here's a scenario that might take place before MyGlue is available. Imagine Lucas from purchasing wants to make an order on Amazon. There are three members of the purchasing team, and they do not order from Amazon very frequently. Lucas visits Amazon.com, types in the username purchasing@skytouch.com, and the password he's recorded in a text file from the last time he logged onto Amazon. The password doesn't work. So Lucas clicks the link, "Forgot your password," which sends an email to all three of them. This starts off a noisy email thread, and then someone types, "Who requested to change password? It's this." Yeah, I know. Somebody just emailed the password. So now the password has changed again. Who knows how it will be communicated and stored this time? This scenario has played out before. Let's look at how Lucas can change his behavior for the next time using MyGlue. So again, he uses the forgot password link on Amazon to give the opportunity to set a new one. This time, Lucas enters MyGlue, creates a password record, and generates a slightly better password than the last one, and then saves it. Lucas can now secure the password to the purchasing team here, via group or via individual user. He doesn't wish to share this account information with his IT provider, so we ensure that no IT groups are selected in this part. In future, should there be a requirement to change that password, it's as simple as editing this record